Hey guys, this is the video that goes along with the Q&A tutorial on strengthening your compositional skills, or at least kind of working on them, exploring them. And I realized when putting the video together that the first half of this video, or at least everything up to this point, is exactly the same as what I did in the video I just made, which was the Josephine Baker one. So essentially, the drawing process, it's the same. Gesture, do a layout, find your structure, draw a final. Though with Nagel, I mean, with a Nagel-like style, you're trying to keep your line work and your detail to a minimum. Because you're going to be working with flats for the whole composition, because, again, the idea is to kind of work fast and to experiment as much as you can with a composition and then move on and try something else. You can either just use a round brush and paint in flats like I'm doing here, which, as you start getting to shapes higher and higher, you've got to be more specific and accurate with how you're drawing. So, fair warning when you're doing stuff like the hair. But otherwise, when you're doing really large areas, like, say, the clothing or whatnot, you can use the magnetic lasso. I find that works really well. Just pick a whole big area, and then hit shift and backspace, and it'll fill it with your foreground color. And keep each of the flat colors on a separate layer, at least for the sake of this kind of, for this experimentational exercise. Leaving all the colors on different layers will make it so that you can keep changing the hue and the value the whole time as much as you want, and when you get to the point where you're going to start trying out different backgrounds and moving shapes around and stuff, it'll make it really easy. I mean, you'll be able to do like 10 different compositions in a minute. I'm assuming this is kind of self-explanatory for most of you guys, but just to be sure, so you know, the sketch is the top layer, and everything that I'm working on with color is below it. So that way, no matter where you paint, you're not going to mess up that sketch or cover it or anything. It helps to stick with pastels for this exercise just because when you're first starting out, one of the easier color schemes to get to work is a pastel one, because when you add that bit of white to everything, which is what you do to make it feel like a pastel, it kind of it groups that whole spectrum. So all of your teals and light pinks and light purples and stuff like that, they all have enough white in them to make them feel unified very easily. So here's where stuff starts to get kind of interesting, because I'm going to start building a lot of extra layers and then saving save states every time I make a significant change in the composition. And I've made a new folder for it, just so that when I am looking at them all together, I'll go into Windows, and I know you can do this in Mac as well, but I will go into Windows and just enlarge the thumbnails and view the folder full of the thumbnails of all these test compositions I've just made in a short period of time. And when you see them all in thumbnails, usually you can kind of get an idea of which ones are working and which ones aren't. So here I've lowered the transparency so I can kind of see where the lines and the flat colors aren't matching up perfectly. So now what I'm doing is I'm locking the layers and using lighter values. I'm putting color into all the areas that are not part of the outline. It's something I like to do just because it makes the inside of the figure sort of more simple and clean. Nagel doesn't always do it. Sometimes he'll have hard black lines in his clothes, and sometimes everything inside the outline will be lighter values, and I'm going with that second option because I think I think it's better for helping out the silhouette and kind of keeping the picture minimalist. Alright, so hopefully you guys found this exercise to be interesting. Again, you can kind of see, if you wanted to take it further, how you could do it. Because basically you just stick with flat colors and keep adding in, I mean, assuming you're using reference, keep adding in things from your reference until it feels like you've lost that that simple quality that the Nagel prints have. Which again, if you go too far past that, you can do it as far as just exploring what you want to do artistically, but you run the risk of kind of spending a long time on things and then maybe not learning as much about composition as you would if you were trying to produce more in a shorter period of time. Like here, even the way I've got kind of three levels of value in her hair, that's pushing it. I mean, if I were to go into a fourth level, I don't think it would suit the picture anymore.